Meet the Crew Podcast. We are the change we desire to see in this world. If you won't change, you have to be the change. We are looking for 3 more hosts to join our team. If you have a message for the world and would like to be a part of the hottest new podcast and media network rocking the podcast world right now, join the Crew Podcast and Media Network. Looking for a little exposure? Allow HTA Enterprises the opportunity to share your brand around the world. We will work with you to develop a package that fits your budget. Contact AEA via email and schedule a consultation. crewpodcast203@gmail.com. We are the change we desire to see.
Aspiring Authors Magazine is a founding sponsor for Da Crew Podcast. Get featured inside the magazine and allow your voice to be heard around the world.
Aspiring Authors Magazine is an international magazine founded in May of 2020 by Queen Angela. Get featured.
Basic Black, After Dark, the all-new podcast show with your host, Blaque Diamond.
Hey everybody, this is Blaque Diamond from the Crew Network, and you're listening to Basic Blaque After Dark Podcast, the show that meets you where you are and gives you what you ask for. Tonight is a special night. We're having 2 celebrations. First is Halloween. Halloween is a celebration observed in many countries on the 31st of October. It's the eve of the Western Christian Feast of All Saints. It begins the observance of All Hallowtide, the time in the liturgical year dedicated to remembering the dead, including saints, martyrs, and all faithful departed. In popular culture, the day has become a celebration of horror, being associated with the supernatural. Now, many Halloween traditions and traditions were influenced particularly by Celtic harvest festivals. But in today's culture, we are trick-or-treating, attending Halloween costume parties, carving pumpkins into jack-o'-lanterns, lighting bonfires, and bobbing for apples. But let's not forget the costumes. Now, I've seen some wonderful costumes from Dracula to Wednesday Addams to Spider-Man and Barbie. No, don't hate on the Barbie. We all played with them. When we were kids and fellows, you had either the Ken doll or those G.I. Joe dolls, or maybe even the soldiers, those toy soldiers and little green things. I used to see them all the time around my house. Well, at least my brothers played with them. Now, I know Halloween is usually a kid celebration, but I saw some adults who were wearing some nice costumes. They had, I think today I saw a few that was the Beyonce alien superstars and Ariel from The Little Mermaid. Now, the teachers, they were definitely keeping it real. A lot of them came dressed in the Disney costumes, and the daycare centers, I have a few grandchildren in the daycare centers, and those babies, they were either in little animals. I know my granddaughter was dressed up as a pink little pig. There was a lot of little farm animals. There were some goats. There was some that was chickens. There was even some baby ones that was dressed as little dogs. The staff was amazing. They did a great job. The kids had some fun. But the most popular for 2023, just take a guess. Take a wild guess of which one it was. Yep. It was the Blue Ivy from the Renaissance World Tour costume that did it in this year. This year, it was amazing to see how many of these kids dressed as Blue Ivy. And you had some adults trying to pull it off too, but you got to give it to the kids. They looked a little better than the adults, but they were doing their thing. Now, I remember when I was growing up, we used to run throughout the neighborhood, ringing doorbells and getting candy, sometimes hiding behind stuff. Now, some people threw eggs. I won't mention any names of who threw them. And some people TP'd homes. You were lucky if you didn't get caught, but that's when kids were kids, eating candy and having fun. And when you think about the time going back of dressing in costumes, well, the costumes were different. they were a little, you think about it now, a little cheap looking. They had, you know, those masks on. Even back then, they were doing more of the presidential ones. I remember a few of them were Nixon. Some of them were Carter. You know, those are the faces. But I wonder if they have the Obama costume with the mask. I think there was a few during his time that they had the Obama one. I'm not sure if they had Michelle, but I'm quite sure they had President Obama, still my president. That's what I'm going to say. He's going to always be my president. But just thinking about going back in that time, how I used to run and, you know, go through the area, we would have not the little trick-or-treat bags. We would have plastic bags because we had more candy. We were a little older, I would say maybe about 13 or 14. Yeah, we were still trick-or-treating then. And we would run from house to house. And the thing about it back then, we knew the house that we were going to. We knew the people. The people kind of knew who we were too. You know, you could basically tell who we were with those little costumes that we had. But we knew whose house to go to. We knew Miss, I won't say her name, but we knew she had the best candy in the neighborhood. So we would often go to her house, and her house was always packed with kids. And sometimes you would even try to go back to get more candy. And she knew who you were, but she always gave us the extra candy. So, you know, we did a lot of traveling around in the community. Again, throwing eggs, playing with each other. And again, that's when kids were kids. That's when it was a little safer to go out into the community and just trick-or-treat and hang with your friends. And even at that time, the candy was different. You know, some of the candy, well, what was your favorite one? What was your favorite Halloween candy? Was it the Skittles? Was it Hershey milk chocolate? Maybe it was the Snickers. Some people even had M&Ms. Yeah, I see Triveda. Yep, the costumes are different these days. And we had the grocery store bag for our candy. Oh, somebody's saying Reese's. Yep, they still have the Reese's. I just went shopping and bought some of those. But yeah, we had the grocery store bag. They held a lot. Those little bags that's about this big, what was they going to hold? Tootsie Rolls, candy corn. Yep, candy corn. My mother loves those candy corns. You can never go bad with the candy corns. And the good thing about the candy corns this time, I know nobody want to give free candy where it's open and, you know, other people's children have to have them. Chocolate. Chocolate is the best. They come in little packets now where it's more protective, and I'm really happy that they did that. But my favorite was Payday. I love the Payday. Now, the thing about it is with the Payday, I was able to eat it then. But years later, I found out that I have some peanut allergies, so I can't even have them. Yep, I just can't be eating the peanut ones. But I know the M&Ms, peanut or plain, they were also good. But I know that it sounds corny, but is anyone still giving out pennies? We used to find it in the bottom of our bag. Yeah, Latonya, you love candy cane too? The candy corn too. We used to find pennies in our bags. And back then you would look and say, I don't want no pennies. Didn't have enough for a costume, had to wear a sheet with holes for eyes. Hey, you got to do what you got to do. You was a ghost, Casper. There you go. Casper was their friendly ghost. Sometimes they still do that. You know, everybody don't always have the money to do that, but you were innovative and you were creative. And I know you, Patrice. Creative and innovative. So you see where you got it from? It was worth cutting the holes in the sheet. Look where you at now. Yes, yep, that's right. Look where you at now. So cutting the holes in the sheet, little black eyes, tying it up with string or rope or whatever you had, it was okay. Now, it may not have felt like it was okay back then. Everybody don't have that luxury of going out and buying costumes. And these costumes are expensive. I had to buy two costumes, one for my son and one for my grandson. Yep, kids breathing with those plastic masks. No, you couldn't breathe in them, but again, they are so creative now and they're expensive. I paid $40 for one costume. No, I don't want to hear it. I don't want to see nobody write nothing that you crazy, you bought it. No, when you love your kids, you love your kids. And they're going to wear it next year too. I was little Bo Peep, 1 year old. That was so adorable. The cute little costumes that they're dressing their babies up and you see sheeps. That was the most fun. Yep. Patrice, growing up as a kid, that was the most fun. growing up and being able to play and playing safe. But you look at it, you know, with the price of everything going up, you got to buy the candy, you got to buy the costume. And the sad thing about it is they want these costumes that are these characters that they see on TV. I'm not shading Disney, but your costumes are expensive. Some families just can't afford it. They honestly cannot afford it. You know, so they do what they have to do. But it's nothing like sitting with your child and making a costume and drawing on the face and using makeup. I guess with little girls, that would be one time you can actually wear makeup. So it was a lot of fun for me growing up. Latonya says, I love Halloween. My son was the Scream character for 3 years straight. Hey, you save money. You may have just changed it and add a little something to it, but there's nothing wrong with being that. And he probably loved it. And thinking about it back then, him looking at it now, how does he dress his daughter? How does he dress his son? Is he a father? Do he dress his kids in a different way than the way that you dress them? May or he may not. But again, it was expensive. Like I said, my kids are going to wear the same costume next year. For $40, we're going to get our money's worth out of it. Believe you me, we're going to get our money's worth out of it. What I want to know is, parents, this Halloween, please be mindful for those who go out without their children. You have to understand that everybody out there is not trick-or-treating. This is that season that some people are lurking in areas where they know there's a lot of children, and these kids are walking around by themselves. They're in costumes, they're running around having fun, and they're just not understanding what's going on. You said that he loved it. I bet you he did. I bet you did. Tell me, you have pictures. He still loves Halloween, and he does make sure that his daughter has a costume. Wonderful. How many of you still have pictures of your kids in those cute little costumes? I call them the blackmail costumes because, you know, you can say how cute they were, but they look like, nah, no, you're not going to show that picture. I think I have a few of them tucked away, and I think I'm going to use those for when I need to have something done around the house. I'm going to use those for, I guess I could just say blackmail. But getting back to being safe out there, you have to monitor your children when they're out there. You have to check their candy when they get it home. I know that this is the dentist's famous and favorite time of the year. Well, it's my kids' favorite time of the year too, because they only get to eat candy twice a year. I know somebody say, oh, you know, they're sneaking candy. Look, I can't monitor them and see everything they're doing, but I do know that I only give them permission to eat candy twice a year. That is for Halloween, and that is for Easter. Those are only two times of the year that I figured it was the best time of the year to allow them to eat candy, because I am not trying to put somebody else's child through college or to pay somebody's mortgage with a dentist bill. Triveda, you says, yes, those costumes are expensive. They are expensive. Yeah, I look, if I can lay away a costume, I'll lay it away. I will lay it away in a minute. There's nothing wrong with putting ten cans together with a string and saying that you're the telephone operator and you walk with your friend down the block. Say something, do something. But the best thing about the Halloween for these kids, I think, is just being out there, having fun. Triveda, you said me too. Yep, I get it. I get it. It's the having fun and running around and just, I guess it's the candy. I guess it's the candy for them. But for me, it's more so staying in the house with my kids, watching scary movies, sitting in our pajamas, telling scary stories, looking at old pictures. I guess for them, it's also ordering pizza. Now, I do buy candy for them. At least I don't have to go check it all the time. And we do put out candy for other kids. But again, I make sure it's the same candy. Make sure that you have to actually pull it open, not the ones with the little twist on it, because anybody can do, and I'm going to say it, anybody can do something with it. They can lace it. I remember back in my time, and I'm not telling anybody to do this, but I'm telling you to check. They used to give out fruit. Hey, unfortunately, you can't steal the grandbaby Snickers this year. I'm going to do that. And that's my grandbaby she's talking about. See, but I can't take the Snickers because it has the peanuts in it. And you know that, and you know you're wrong. You know you're wrong for bringing up those daggone Snickers. But that's all right. I got some candy upstairs hidden for myself, so you're going to have to go looking for it. but I'm going to move away from her because she's just trying to tease me because she knows that I can't eat the Snickers this year because of the peanuts. And we went out and bought a lot. It's nostalgia of it for me. Yes, it is. You get to sit back. You get to relax. You get to watch those grandbabies now and just adore them. You just adore them. You still have those pictures. Good for you, Triveda. Call it blackmail, Triveda. Use those pictures. When you need something, let them know you're going to post them on Facebook. You're going to send them and let their friends see them. Take the pictures of the grandbabies, too, because they're going to grow up. And you're going to need those pictures. Because, you know, the older we get, the more they're going to want from us. So use those pictures to blackmail them. But in a good way. In a good way. You know, rake the grass. Wash the dishes. Do whatever you have to do. Dangle those pictures over them because it works. It works for me because the little smarty that got on it just now talking about the grandbaby and the peanut Snickers, I got you. I got something for you. I have some pictures of you. And if I'd have known you was going to come on here tonight and do that, I would have got a picture of you and hold it up. But I'm going to be on the show next week and the week after that. So I got some baby pictures of you. I don't think you're going to like it, but I'm going to show it anyway. You can go upstairs and try to look for it, but I got them hidden. See, this is what you get. This is exactly what you get for trying to play your mother. Oh, you want to laugh? Got jokes. Okay, I got jokes too. Remember, you sleep hard. Reese's Cups. You're talking about all the stuff with the peanuts and the peanut butter. Okay, that's cool. That's all right. Not the black man. Yeah, see, now here's the thing. She want to be smart, and I know I'm getting off the subject, but she want to be smart. Now, watch her apologize real quick. Her birthday coming in January. Her birthday, mom, no, yep. Yep, you knew where I was going with it. Your birthday's coming in January, and you're going to need a babysitter. See where those M&Ms get you then. See where that peanut goes then. That's right, yep, I got tricks too. So I want an apology. Come on, you can do it. Be a big girl, apologize on it. You got on here and tried to play me, so apologize on it. I want to see it. I want to see it go right across the screen. I apologize, mommy. I wasn't right. Come on. Now, you know you're going to want to go out. And then you got the holiday coming, Christmas. You got the new year you're going to want to go out. And your birthday's right behind that. Yep, I'm pulling all of those. I'm pulling all of those cards out. Yep, I got you. I got you. And you're going to sit here crying, mom. You know, I was just joking. Oh, so was I. Good night. Have a happy. And that's all I'm going to say to you. And I can hear her laughing through the walls. You can laugh all you want. Watch what happens come January. You know what? I'm going to make it my business to see if I can be on the show on your birthday. And I'm going to be sitting here relaxing while you sitting in another room celebrating your birthday in another room. Since you want to call your mother out on those daggone peanuts, you know you wasn't right. But that's all right. I got something for you. I got something for you. Yes, I do. Well, anyway, I'm going to get back to this because she tried to be slick and take me off of here. But Easter and Halloween were the time of the year. She's probably trying to get back at me because she was one of my children that couldn't have the candy either. But she should be grateful for it now because I do it with my grands. But for the most part, like I said, I stay home with my kids. I order some pizza. I watch some crazy movies in my pajamas. And we just call it a night. Now, we do, you know, have some fun. We make little things. And I should have made some Jell-O this year, but I didn't. You know, Jell-O was just something that wasn't on my mind. Oh, yeah, wow, yeah, here we go. The best free babysitter. Nope, I'm put a dollar sign behind it. I apologize in large writing, mommy. I'm so very, very, very sorry. Dinner is waiting for you. Well, guess what? I'm not even hungry. I lost my appetite. January when? I'm a January baby. She's January the 25th. And I know you're not like her all the time. I'm definitely the mom to use pictures of my kids. I did it to my daughter for her senior year. Go ahead, Triveda. While she was in high school, I put the picture with the potty seat on her head. Woo! Go ahead, Triveda. Yep, I know. I'm going to be digging through those pictures, though. She want to be smart, though. I'm going to go through those pictures. And you know what? Hers is January 25th. Yep. But you know what? Since she opened up her mouth, oh, okay. Yours is 24. Since she opened her mouth, I'm going to get her brothers, too. Now, how you like me now, I'm going to get your brothers too. I'm going to get them for the same. And their birthday is in December and January. His is the 14th and the other one is the 22nd. Birthday's right around. I'm going to pay them too. I'm going to pay them a visit. Because of your mouth, I'm going to get there. Mm-hmm. Your grandmother always said, nothing defiles the body but what comes out of the mouth. So if you ever heard her say that, now you know what she means by that. Remember, nothing defiles the body but what comes out of the mouth. So your body and your mouth will be sitting here on January 25th. As a matter of fact, you're going to be sitting here on December 31st. Right along with me. Well, we got a celebration coming up. Yeah, guilty by association. Yeah, that's what you do. Guilty by association. No, don't try to suck up now to people saying, hey, Aquarius, you just forget all about that. That's not even going to help you now. Don't come on my show trying to be nice to people because you messed up. Yeah. Mm-hmm. See, I'm not going to get the grandkids because of you. I'm going to let them slide. I'm going to go ahead and do what I got to do for them. I'm going to let them slide. I'm going to give them what they deserve. Well, anyway, early in the show, I mentioned that we have two celebrations tonight. Halloween was one of them. And the second is the Crew Podcast Network's 150th show. The Crew Podcast and I would like to thank you for hanging in there with us for 150 shows. We hope you enjoyed us as much as we loved having you and tuning in to us. We want you to continue to tune in, subscribe, and follow us because we have so much more to bring you. This, the Crew Podcast, we got a lot of things coming up. We have some celebrations coming up. Yep, 150th episode. There you go. It's not just my show. It's a lot of us on the crew. Some wonderful ladies and a gentleman as well who's sharing in this celebration of 150 episodes. So you're not just tuning in and celebrating my show. You're tuning in and celebrating their shows. As a matter of fact, you can catch everybody's show at 8 o'clock Eastern Standard Time, Sunday through Saturday. You're going to catch one of us, and you're going to enjoy the show. I guarantee you, because I enjoy working with these people. It's been 1 year. Well, almost a year. We'll celebrate that next year, so we're just going to keep celebrating. We're going to celebrate all the way around. Yep, whoop, whoop, whoop. We're going to celebrate all year round, and it's worth celebrating because we're going to celebrate you. We love to celebrate you. We just want you to keep tuning in because we have so much to bring you. We're going to be talking about just so many different topics, so many different things that's happening in your community and in our community. Some things that may be happening in the news, some things that may be happening in your neighborhood. But here's something special for you. Because you like it so much, you can join the team. You see it going across? We are pulling in people. We're encouraging you to join us, be a part of the family. You're going to be trained by a wonderful person. That's my producer. Yep, the crew hosts are the best. Yep, I can say that. Pop a couple of collars. My daughter's going to hate on me for that one. It is the best. And I'm not saying that because I'm a part of it. Well, maybe I am. But they're not paying me to say it. But they are the best. When I say they're like family, it's not just family because it's called the crew. It's because when this show is over, we still have connections to each other. We connect with each other. We talk to each other. And we want you to be a part of this family. We want you to come and join the crew. Patrice, she's one of them. She's part of the family. Triveda is part of the family. Latonya is part of the family. My daughter's going to be up for adoption, so don't even think she's not even part of my family anymore. So anybody want her, they can take her. Yeah, I'm getting a little salty tonight with her. But yeah, these are our family members. You're seeing them come in, they're popping in, and they're supportive. We're supportive to you. You join the crew, you're going to be trained throughout the month of January. We have our producer, Ms. Angela Thomas Smith, who's going to be there with you 100%. She's going to be with you. She's going to take you through this journey. We're going to be there supporting you as well. We're going to be in there. You're going to be doing some mock interviews with us. You know what? I'm not going to give you any more than that. Just come and join us. Join the crew. You're going to be happy that you did because we got a lot of things coming up for next year. We got a lot of surprises for a lot of people. So we want you to be a part of this network. The Crew Network. We are the best. Come live, laugh, love, and learn with us because we're still learning. We're learning about this wonderful network. We're not adoption. We're learning about each other. But more than that, we're learning about ourselves because I've learned a lot about myself. I'm going to be honest, I didn't think that I would ever do a podcast. Now, I'll be a guest. on anybody's show, but to sit and to talk to people, I always say, I didn't have anything to talk about. People not going to listen to me. Shoot, my kids barely want to listen to me, but they're grown now, most of them. But I found so many wonderful people that wanted their stories told. So many people that did not have their own voice, and they asked me to use my voice for their voice, and I did. And I'm continuing to do that. We are the change we desire to see in this world, and we want you to be a part of this right here, right now. So while you're sitting here tonight and watching us, you see all the information on there? You can go and DM me. You can speak to the Crew Podcast. We're on almost every social media network there is. Sammy, I never imagined myself doing this. See, a lot of us didn't imagine ourselves doing this. But Angela made it easy. She made it comfortable. And she made us feel like we were family. The Crew Aspiring Authors Magazine. I come with four kids and a 90-year-old man. No, she didn't. See, now you don't put my mama out there. Now you want to go for it. You're talking about my mother. Now you know you're going to have some problems. You didn't have to put your grandmother out there, and you didn't have to tell her age. But I'm going to tell her that you went out there and you put her out there. You're selling your grandmother. That's sad. But I'm going to tell her what you said. Mm-hmm. Watch me. And my grandkids is not a part of your package. You by yourself. Mm-hmm. Well, anyway, see, that's some of the stuff that we do here. We have a lot of fun. We do play a lot of jokes on each other, but we're serious. We're serious about you. We're serious about what we do. We want you to join us. Watch us on the 31st. But of course, we're going to be bringing in the new year. Oh, you're going to take my mother? You know what? I can use the vacation. Y'all go ahead and have her. Packing your bags now. You're not packing them fast enough, because I don't hear too much moving around. And when you pack your bag, you got a one-year-old. I don't feel like changing Pampers. I love her. You can bring her back after she done finished all of that pooping in the pamper and the potty changing and getting up in the middle of the night. You can take her with you, but when she gets a little older, you can bring her back, because I love my granddaughter. You see how we do? Y'all sound like my kids. Hey, this is the way we are. This is what we do here on the Crew. I love to have a nana. Yeah, my mom's a piece of work. She's a work in progress, though. She will be, and I'll say it, she will be 99 years old on Valentine's Day. 99 years old. So I have no idea what I'm going to do with her this year for her 99th birthday, but I know it's going to be something. But I can just imagine her 100th birthday. Man, oh man, it's going to be something. And y'all are invited. But you can't tell her. But I know she's going to do like she did this year. She's going to start picking him. Yeah, we celebrating. Yeah, we are. You know, we're going to say it's going to be big. It's going to be big. 99 years. See, I don't want to go any further, because if I tell you a little bit more about it, then you'll figure out how old I am. And my daughter bet not say anything. She want to stay here. Your son was born on Valentine's. Oh, okay. She's your new nana. Yes, she is. Yes, she is. She's everybody's nana. She's everybody's grandma. Now, you're going to have some competition in a minute, because I know somebody's going to come in and tell you something about that's her grandmother. Now, I ain't going to tell you who she is, but she's going to pop on in a minute, and she's going to tell you that's just her grandmother, because she's spoiled. She's her crybaby granddaughter. She's spoiled, and her grandmother spoils her. If she knows them on, she's like, who's that? Is that my granddaughter? Is that my crybaby granddaughter? Yeah, Mom. That's her. She's on here. What's she doing? She's doing everything, and I keep telling her to relax. Yep. That's the crybaby granddaughter right there. So we are going to celebrate her. We're going to celebrate her. She enjoyed last year's. I have an idea who you're talking about. Yeah, you guessed it. That's her. She'll cry in a minute, but we love her. And you can see why. That's why we want you to join the Crew. Now, I'm not going to promise you that I'm going to share my mom with you, but you can get to know her, because sometimes I interview my mom. She's an author. She's an author just like me, or I'm an author just like her. And she has a lot to say. Believe me, she has a lot to say, and she'll say it too. She's one person Well, I put it like this. She does speak her mind when she feels like it's necessary to speak her mind. And that's most of the time. But you got to give me away. Oh, yeah. Yeah, you know you're going. You were going. I thought you were packing your bags. And did I see somebody say something about an Uber? You packing your bags, but you still on here. How? Mm-hmm. Yeah, I kind of thought so. You don't want to go no place. You snitching on. You ain't got to tell. I'll tell myself. Matter of fact, I'll replay this for her. And I'll let her know what you said about her. And I'll let her know. Yeah, you go ahead, Patrice. Call that Uber. You must know how I feel. Go ahead and call that Uber, Patrice. And I'll give you, I'll DM you my address so they make sure that they're on time. See, I would have given her a ride, but I'm not. Let her get in the Uber, let her pay for it with a smart mouth. But again, I'm going to tell you, you love an Uber. Jesus. She's a piece of work. She is her grandmother's granddaughter. Both of them are a piece of work. Matter of fact, both of them under the same sign. So you could imagine what I go through here in the house. Tesla, please. Mm. But you see, again, this is why we want you to join us. We have a lot of fun. We will take you to. See, I thought we were here. She's not a part of the crew. She's just a plus one. How do you take that you're going to take her in? She's giving me problems and we together. You see, Latonya? See how you became a turncoat? It was that easy. Mm-hmm. She turned you. How? How did that happen? 2 seconds ago, you were on my side, but now you're talking about you're going to take her too. Oh, yeah. You're special, all right. Yeah, y'all are special. That's okay. Remember that when your birthday comes. Yeah, thank you, sweetie. There go my baby. Shaking her head. Knowing you know how she is. She went there tonight. But you know something that's funny? I don't hear no movement in the house. The house is quiet. Quiet. So she's probably upstairs mopping the floor, washing the dishes. And then she's going to tell me that she's got a plate of food ready for me. Yeah, uh-huh. Mm-hmm. Now, I was born this month, but not this year. So you keep your food. Because right now, I'm not even trusting because you ready to do some numbers on me. Talking about you're going to tell your grandmother and you're going to take her with you. Okay. And she be getting on your nerves. You'll be howling about you're going to take her with you. Let's wait till tomorrow morning. When she get up and she feeling herself. Let's see how much you're talking about. I'm going to take her with me. When she's asking you for her coffee. When she's telling you that it's not sweet enough. When she's telling you that she needs some more. Oh, bro. Mm-hmm. She in trouble? Yes, she's in trouble. Oh, boy. She just don't know how much trouble she in. She really don't know. And you studying for your boards? And you need it quiet? And you're going to need a ride there? Mm-hmm. Yeah. I see you. I see you for who you really are. You showing all your colors, Miss Blue. Mm-hmm. I got you. Got something for you, too. Now, that's not a threat. That's just the way I speak. And I got into trouble for that one time. I said something in the state that I'm living in. And I'm from New York. So I speak. And the way that I speak, I don't apologize for what I say. But when people say certain things and I say something back and I give you a response, because that's all it is a response, you get offended. And I'm not here to offend anybody, but there is a language difference. And I'm not going to say a barrier, it's a difference. Now, I'll give you an example from where I'm at. My brother had a female friend come visit him in New York. And she was speaking the way I guess she speaks from where she was coming from. And she happened to say to him, I'm going to dot you in the eye and I'm going to bang you. So being from New York, when you tell somebody you're going to bang them, what do you think that means? That means that you're going to shoot them. That's what I took it as, and that's what everybody else around us took it as. But she got a pass because she didn't know. Now, I moved to the state that she's in, and I went into the store, and I asked the gentleman, can I have 4 wings, chicken wings, and some French fries. He asked me, did I want a chicken box? So I'm looking at him and saying to him, no, I want four wings, chicken wings, and some French fries. And he kept saying, did I want a chicken box? I said, mister, I don't want a box of chicken. And I'm thinking, like, a box of chicken from home is different than here. So I let that go. And I said, if that's what it is, then yes, that's what I want. So he asked me, did I want something to drink? And I said, yes, I do want something to drink. Can I get tea with lemon? He asked me, did I want a half and half? So at this point, I started getting annoyed because I said, if I wanted a half and half, I would go to the supermarket and I would get a half and half. Because to me, the half and half is, you know, the cream that you put in your coffee or whatever it is you're going to have, or your cereal, whatever it is. So I'm looking at him like, no, I want some tea with some lemon. And he just kept going on with this half and half. So I said, I'm done. I had no idea what he was talking about, but that's what they call it here. So, you know, I heard him. I still say it the way that I want to say it. And that's the way I get along here. Now, here's one of the things that I was really baffled about. I was driving my car and my car stalled. So I said that I needed, right, an Arnold Palmer. They just don't get it. If I would have said that, they would have just been looking for the golfer. So I just knew not to even go there with the Arnold Palmer, if that's even if they knew what it was. So my car got stalled. So I said, I need a boost. The gentleman said, you need some help? I said, yes, I need a boost. He said, excuse me? He said, I can give you a hot shot. Now, here we go again, being from New York. I'm thinking, he's talking about hot shot. I'm thinking about this guy trying to shoot me. But a hot shot here is what we call a boost, and that's just to get our car jump started. I had no idea what he was talking about, but he jump started my car, and I got out of there just as quick as I could because I had no idea what was going on. That's the language that they spoke here. And when you go to different communities and you go to different states, I feel as though you need to have a dictionary. And it's not an ethnic thing or any racial thing. It's just that you need to know what the lingo is when you're in that state, because there could be bad mistakes. People can take language. See, now somebody's saying, a jump off could be plenty of things. So I ain't gonna go there with a jump off. So I'm gonna act like you didn't even say that. But I got a feeling that you, I know what you meant with the car, but somebody else said something else. Somebody said, Boost, I would have said, no, I don't need you to steal me. You see what I'm saying? Now, we're all from different places, and this is what I'm talking about. People say different things. So many people think that I have an accent. You know, and they'll say, oh, I know you're from New York. I say, no, I'm from Jersey. Because sometimes I feel like they're trying to be a little smart with it, but it is what it is. But now here's something, no matter what state I'm in, and my daughter, I'm going to say it low. My daughter have a problem with me saying it. So she'll say, Mom, I'm going to get something from Chick-fil-A. I say that it's Chick-fil-A. Look at the way that it's spelled. It's F-I-L-A. Growing up, you had a pair of filas on. Filet is spelled what? F-I-L-E-T-T. That's a filet. Filet of fish. So I know and I feel strong about it that I'm saying it right. It's Chick-fil-A. She says it's Chick-fil-A. We say boost off and jump off here in South Carolina. See, that's what I'm saying. So I'm glad you told me, because now when I come to visit, well, you know what? When I come to visit, I'm just going to call you, tell you to pick me up. I'm not going to drive because I'll be in all sorts of trouble. I'll probably be going up a street that I'm thinking I can go down, and it's probably a one-way street. See, that's what I'm saying. There you go. I agree. It's like the shoe. Fila, there you go. Now, I hope she's listening to that, little Miss Smarty. Where you at now? I say the same thing. It's Fila, F-I-L-A. So I say, and I sit around people, I say, no, I don't want any Chick-fil-A. And they look, and I'm like, well, no, I don't want, whatever you said it was, I don't want that. But I say it's Chick-fil-A. They have good food. Don't get me wrong. I'm not trying to come down, but that's just the way that I pronounce it. And I'm not saying that I speak proper English, because I don't speak the Queen's English. So if I went over there to London, they would laugh at me, because what we speak is broken English here. And I'm not laughing at anybody in the state that I'm in. I'm just saying that we speak, our meanings for certain things are different. And if you don't know, then what you should do is say, what do you mean by that? simple thing. What do you mean by that? And that can reduce a lot of tension between people, and it can reduce a lot of arguments, fussing, fighting. Just ask the person, what do you mean? You don't have to fight. You don't have to argue. Simple thing. What do you mean by that? It can take care of so much just by asking that simple question. Well, it's Halloween. I'm hearing some movement upstairs, so I think the kids, either the pizza's here or either somebody's at the door and they're here to get some candy. But I thank you all so very much for joining me tonight. I want to wish everybody a happy Halloween. Stay safe. Join us in the new year. Be a part of our family. You can reach out to me or to anybody on the crew. We would love to have you here. DM any one of us. Go on YouTube. You'll see us there. You'll see us on Facebook. You'll see us everywhere. You'll find one of us someplace. Join the crew. Get off. Thank you, my baby, for taking her off. I absolutely love you too, Latonya. See, these are my sisters, my family. I love them. Love you, Grace. Thank you so much, Patrice. She's part of the family. Please, happy Freeloaders Day. Oh, you see, now y'all know what I'm talking about. You see, now you know what I'm talking about with this child of mine. She's calling some people freeloaders, but she forgot that she used to run around out there in them little costumes that I used to get her to, begging for candy. So that's what I'm going to call you, begging for candy. Knocking on doors, begging for candy. Holding your bag open, looking pathetic. I know. I'm your mama, so I know. Good night, everybody. Be safe.
Basic Black, After Dark, the all-new podcast show with your host, Blaque Diamond.